Hello, Power BI community. I'm Patrick LeBlanc, Principal Program Manager, Microsoft Fabric, and welcome to the June 2025 Power BI Monthly Update. This month's update includes GA announcements, some new public preview features, and a call to action. Let's dive in and see what's new in June. Let's start with the GA announcements. Sparklines are now generally available. But the best part of this announcement is that they can be used with calculation groups for greater control. The calculation group can either be applied per data point or across the entire Sparkline. We have a demo from Jay explaining all of this in detail. Let's jump in.
In this demo, we'll explore how Power BI's Sparkline settings affect how calculation groups are applied. By default, calculation groups apply to the individual values on the Sparkline, but we can configure them to evaluate all points collectively. Let's walk through an example. First, I've created a field parameter that sets a threshold value called big sales size. It is currently set to 1 million. Then I've created a measure that compares the sum of gross sales against the big sales size, and if it's high or equal, it returns true, otherwise false. Also, I've added a calculation group that contains three items. First one is just returning selected measure. The second returns the value of selected measure for if big sales is true. So only if the sales is above the threshold, it will return a selected measure value. Otherwise, it will return blank. And then the third one, which we'll see a little later, is a calculation that performs a percentage of grand total, which divides the selected measure by the all selected of the selected measure. So effectively calculates a grand total. Great. Let's go back to the report. I have created a matrix that shows the sum of gross sales by product. And I've also added a Sparkline that shows the sum of gross sales by month number. So there's 12 dots on each Sparkline, one for each month number. And then we go down the matrix for each product and we show the same. We show the trend of the sum of gross sales. The calculation group currently is set to actual, which means they're just the actuals that are being shown. And since the Sparkline by default is set to apply the calculation group to individual values, each month's sales is assessed separately. Now, let's change the calculation group using a slicer to actual for big sales only. And when I do that, the Sparkline will only show for month product combinations where the gross sales exceeds that 1 million threshold. To explain what's happening here, I've added a matrix here at the bottom that shows the same information as the Sparkline, but this time with values and a conditional formatting rule. It shows product and month number and the sum of gross sales. And as you can see, there's only a few combinations that exceed that 1 million threshold here. So since that only happens a couple times, the points on the Sparkline only show for those instances and not for the others, since the calculation group evaluates to blank for those. So in this setup, the calculation group evaluates each individual point and compares it against the threshold. And if it's above the threshold of 1 million, it returns the value, otherwise it would turn blank. So that's why the Sparkline is very sparse. Now let's change the Sparkline configuration to applying to the whole Sparkline, so the entire Sparkline. So this is a new setting. You can now switch it to entire Sparkline. When I do this, you'll see that all the Sparklines are back. But what happens here? Well, now the calculation considers the total gross sales across all month, and that compares that value, that total value of the sum of gross sales for all months against the cutoff value. And of course, as you can see here, all of those are above 1 million. However, if I increase the big sales size to 3 million, we'll see that the value and the Sparkline for the ones that were below 3 million disappear. And as you can see here on the right, the matrix here on the right that I created using the same kind of a conditional formatting rule shows that as well, right? The Corrida and Montana product are now not highlighted because they're below the threshold. So what happens here is that the calculation group now treats all the values of the sum of gross sales by month number for each product The sum of those sales as the value to compare against the big sales size. Now, applying an arithmetic operation like percentage of grand total to a Sparkline that is set to where the calculation group applies to the whole Sparkline is not supported. So if I switch my aggregate to the percent of grand total, remember that did a divide, which is an arithmetic operation. If I do this, the matrix will error out and will tell me you cannot do this. You need to convert the calculation group to individual values. So then we actually can apply the mathematical operation. You can simply fix this by either converting it to individual values yourself using the dialog we've just shown over here, or just press the convert button and we'll convert the Sparkline for you. So in this demo, we've seen how calculation groups can be applied at the individual or the whole Sparkline level, and how whole Sparkline enables aggregations across all the data points in the Sparkline, as well as that some calculations like mathematical operations, like a divide or what have you, do not work with whole Sparkline. You can only apply those to when the Sparkline is set to individual values, which is the default setting. And so try experimenting with different calculations in your Power BI reports and see how the Sparklines behave.
Thanks for the great demo, Jay. Now, let's talk about what's completely new in June. All the public preview features. Remember, these are just the highlight of some of the great new features. For a full list of all the announcements, make sure you check out the updates blog. You can find a link in the video description below. The first announcement is big news. Big news, I tell you, for Power BI fans. Everyone has been waiting for this. You can finally add tables to import models using Power Query in the web. What does this mean? Well, we've got a great demo from Emily where she provides all the details. Let's check it out.
We are so excited to announce that one of the most requested features for semantic model editing on the web is finally here. Power Query editing for import models is launching this month. Since we introduced data model editing in the service, many of you have told us that Power Query was the final missing piece for a truly end-to-end in-browser authoring experience. Well, the wait is finally over. Starting this month, you will be able to connect to data, transform it, and refresh your import models all directly in the web, no desktop needed. Let's take a look at what this looks like. I'll start by selecting the Transform Data button to open the Power Query editor. From here, I can bring in new data using my favorite connectors in the Get Data dialog, or I can apply rich transformations right within the browser. In my example, I'm working with an employee table. And here I see separate columns for first and last names, but for reporting, I want them combined. I can easily create a custom column using this dialog, no code required. After saving this change, I can see what my new column looks like here within the data preview. Next, I want to clean up some values. In the title column, I notice an outdated role name, Tool Designer. Our company now uses Junior Tool Designer, so I'll use the Replace Values option to update all of these references accordingly. This was another easy transformation I was able to make in just a few simple clicks. To get a broader view of my transformations, I switched to the diagram view in the modern Power Query online experience. This gives me a visual map of all applied steps and suggestions for additional changes I might want to make. Once I'm happy with my data prep, I simply save and apply, and just like that, my changes are committed back to the model, all within the web. All of these rich Power Query transformations to my import model were done entirely in the web, without any need to switch between tools or even launch desktop. We'd love to hear your feedback on this experience. Let us know what you think about this Power Query editing capability and editing your semantic models in the web overall by sharing your thoughts in our feedback form. You can also check out our documentation for more details, including current limitations.
Amazing demo, Emily. Next up, Power BI gets a boost with some great new features for visual calculations with the introduction of parameter pickers. Now, it's easier and faster to work with visual calc templates, and your reports will hold up better even if you make a mistake. Want to learn more? Jay has a demo that explains how. Let's take a look.
We've got a couple of cool new features for visual calculations this month. First up, parameter pickers. Creating visual calculations now got even easier. New this month are parameter pickers, a fast and intuitive way to select required values with just a couple of clicks. Here I'm picking the moving average template and the parameter picker shows up. There's no more guessing or manual typing. When you use a function exclusive to visual calculation, the parameter picker automatically shows up for all required parameters with predefined options. And then it is just a matter of point and click. And the colored highlights keep everything visually aligned between the formula bar and the matrix, so you always know what data you're working with. And if you prefer manual input, no problem. Just start typing, and as soon as you enter a valid value, the parameter picker will show up again, so it's easy to continue making further changes. Keep in mind that parameter pickers are available only for required parameters in exclusive visual calculation functions with predefined options. Parameters with open text or numerical input, such as the window size parameter on the moving average function here, won't get any pickers. But of course, you can just use typing to enter it. Parameter pickers are fast, simple, and efficient, so try them out today. The next update has to do with axis references. Ever change your visual type and suddenly encountered errors when using visual calculations? That's a thing of the past, because starting with this release, visual calculations won't break due to missing axis references. So to show you that, previously, if you use an axis reference like columns here, that is not available on a bar chart, if you commit this calc previously, this would break the visualization. But now, invalid axis references are simply ignored, allowing your calculation to continue to work and your visual won't break. For instance, if you did this, the result simply equals the value of the total product cost and that's it. So the axis is actually just ignored. And then the final update for visual calculations this month is the integration into Explore. So Explore already makes it easy to dive into your data, but now it's even more powerful thanks to visual calculations. You can now create visual calculations directly in Explore, whether from the matrix or from the visual here at the bottom, and just click New Visual Calculation to get started. And the same familiar interface as before that you might be familiar with in reports shows up, which is called the Visual Calculations Edit Mode, complete with highlights, templates, and parameter pickers that I've just shown you. And once you're ready to add this calculation onto the matrix or to the visual, you go back into the Explorer, and then the other visual will also show that same calculation. In case the other visual cannot display the data, it will enter an error state, but no worries, you can simply adjust the visual type or remove the calculation to get back on track. So by combining Explorer with visual calculations, your data analysis is faster, more intuitive, and more powerful than ever before.
Thanks, Jay, for such an amazing demo. Are you using Power BI Mobile? Are you using Org Apps? Good news. Org Apps just landed in preview on Power BI Mobile app. Now you can find them right alongside your workspace apps. And the navigation is super simple, designed just for mobile users. Even cooler, you can use features like NFC tags for instant access. Curious how to give it a try? Let's check out this amazing demo from Maya.
Org Apps are now available in the Power BI Mobile app. Let's take a look at a workspace. You can now view all of the org apps in a workspace. You can use the new apps filter to filter a workspace by apps. You can also view org apps alongside workspace apps in the app section. Now, let's open the org app. When creating this app in the Power BI service, I added an overview page which acts as the landing page in this app. This page, as well as the entire app, support the same theme defined in the service. The overview page displays the app title, description, and content, and is fit for mobile. Sections are, of course, supported as well, just like in workspace apps. You can expand and collapse them as needed. The overview page allows you to navigate to any item in the app. To move to another item in the app or return to the overview page, you can use the app navigation tree, which is the mobile version of the app navigation pane and includes all of the supported app content, or simply press back. Fabric artifacts that are not supported in mobile, such as notebooks and real-time dashboards, will appear in the org app content. You can tap the item to view info about it and use the View on Web button to open it in the browser. The org app also appears on the homepage under Recents and Frequents and are searchable like any other Power BI item.
Thanks for the great demo, Maya. Last up, we have a call to action. The Azure Maps visual in Power BI has some big updates, and there's something you need to do. Admins now get more control over where location data is stored, especially for US and EU customers whose data now stays within those regions. With the June release, admins should review and or update the new Azure Map tenant settings. Log in and check out your settings today. That concludes the updates for June. We encourage you to visit our Power BI community forums at aka.ms/PBI community, where you can connect with peers and find answers to all your questions. Remember, your feedback truly matters to us. We're always listening. If there are specific demos or topics you'd like us to cover in the future, please let us know. And as always, if you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post them in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. And if it's your first time here, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all Power BI features and updates. Remember, thanks for watching. We'll see you next month.